Oh, and start already?
Yeah. Hey guys.
Not this game.
You're such a clown.
Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. I'm saying my channel because it's not our channel anymore because she ditched me. She left
me. No, actually she told me to leave, but I was like, what, I'm a girl, it's I, but yeah.
She lying. Anyways, guys, as you guys can see from the title, we are going to be filming today on how to get him to put a ring on it. Yes. Oh, let me just rewind for a second and say that if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, hit the subscribe button. I like the video and share it already.
Yes. Then you can come over my channel.
What's your channel subscribe. Name, by the way?
The name of my channel is Olivia Face. And it's pretty much going to be the same thing, like her channel, makeup, you know, hair, all that jazz. And a little bit of, you know, talking videos like the one we're going to do now. So, just to start it off, like the title says, we're going to talk about how to get him to put a ring on it. So, just a disclaimer, she's married and I am currently engaged to be married. So we're just gonna, you know, just talk about fun things and like things that you have to do to basically get him to put a ring on it.
Yes. That's just our little title or way of saying, you know, basically just steps to take in getting to that step of marriage. Not like we hold him down to put a ring on it or anything like that.
It's or stuff that you have to do. It's just basically our point of view. You know, everyone else's point of views are obviously different. But, you know, we just want to talk about the things that we think are important.
Yeah, so the first thing that I want to say is definitely pray. I prayed a lot about getting married and having a husband and qualities in a husband and what I wanted him to be. And I've been in a relationship before I got married. So my biggest problem, my biggest issue that I had in my past relationship was infidelity, and I could not stand it. I hated it. You guys know what that's like.
I mean, no one likes.
No one likes.
Or even wants to deal with that.
Exactly. So I had prayed a lot about that. And a lot of other things. So I would say the number one thing to do before you even meet the guy or meet this person, or even if you're in a relationship, you're already with the person, definitely pray, because you got to put God in the front, honey.
Yeah.
You got to put God in at the front. Mm-hmm. All right?
I agree too. So definitely pray. Me, on the other hand, I, you know, obviously would pray too, but for me, like in my past, I wasn't really like, you know, looking for anybody, but at the same token, I would still pray and just ask God to bring me the guy that, you know, I know he's gonna deliver to me, which is somebody amazing. So even though I wasn't, you know, out there seeking someone, I was still praying in the process, you know, leading up to when I met my fiance. So praying is definitely number one.
All right, number two, I would definitely say be yourself. You can't fake it, you can't act, you can't pretend to be someone that you're not. Say, I'm a person that don't like makeup, or I don't like to wear weaves, or, you know, I don't like to dress in tight clothes, and then I met this guy and I feel like that's what he likes. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden you run, you know, you run to go buy a wig and you go buy makeup, and then you start doing this stuff to impress this guy, and then a month later you're like, I'm tired of this, I don't like this, I like to wear my natural hair, I don't like to have all that stuff on my face. Mm-hmm. And then you change, then that's gonna be like, oh my, he's gonna be looking at you like, oh my God, what happened? Because that's not the person who I met. Mm-hmm. So, and that could be with anything. Maybe you hate cooking, but all of a sudden you on the phone talking to this guy, telling him, oh, I like to cook, and then tell him, oh, I cooked yesterday and this is what I made. If you don't like to cook, don't say you love to cook and pretend like, you know, could be cooking and stuff like that, because at the end of the day, it's just not gonna work. Because then you're put on a facade. Mm-hmm. Of some or being someone or doing something that you don't like. So I would definitely say, yeah, be yourself.
Just to, you know, wrap up what we were saying, just to be yourself and don't try to be like anyone else, because he's only gonna love you for you. He's not, you know, loving you because you have long hair, or, you know, you wear heels, or you love to cook, or whatever. Just be yourself.
All right, guys. If you see me looking down, I'm looking at my phone because we actually try to write everything down so we don't forget. But the next point that I have, or the next thing that I wrote down, is know what you want in a friendship, a relationship, and then a partnership. And that all ties in together. I feel like when you first meet the person, you should try to be their friend, because a friend is someone that try to understand the other person and not just care about themselves. And definitely being friends first before you go into a relationship, it helps a lot because you get to know each other better.
Right.
Instead of, okay, you know, you meet the person and then, okay, we're dating, you're mine, I'm yours. People tend to get possessive sometimes, a lot of jealousy coming to place. I feel like you definitely need to be good friends with the person so you get to know them and understand them, know what they like, let them get to know you in a sense before you get into a relationship. So I would definitely say know exactly what you want and then get to know the person at the same time, what they like.
Right. You also want to make sure that you're completely, you know, comfortable around that person. Like, I can do anything around my fiance. We'll just, like, sit there and laugh. You don't want to be, like, be around this person and then you got a fart and you just be like, oh my God, like, I don't want to do it because I'm with him. You know what I mean? You guys are around your girlfriends, like your best friend. You do whatever around your best friend. You, like, laugh or just say silly things around your best friend. Partner should be your best friend. That should be the person that you're just like 100% just utterly and completely comfortable around. So yeah,
I actually met this, I used to work with this guy actually, and we were talking randomly one day about fart, I don't know why, and he was saying how he's so scared of fart and his wife could never fart around him. And I'm like, but that's nature. If I have to get up, if my husband and I are laying down watching TV and I need to fart and I need to get up and go to the bathroom and close the door to fart, that's not going to work, honey. It's not going to work. I mean, everyone has their thing that they like and their thing that they don't like. In my case, or how I feel about that, that's nature. If my husband got a fart, like, what am I supposed to do?
Yeah, it's not even just about farting. It's
like, a lot of other things.
Yeah, just like a lot of other things. If you're wearing makeup around your husband, fiance, whatever, and you feel like he's never seen you without makeup, that's a problem. Or if he has a problem with you not wearing makeup, then that's a problem.
Exactly.
Or you wearing makeup and he has a problem with it, that's a problem too. Like, you both should be able to just be yourself completely, and he should be able to accept you of who you are, and you should be able to accept him too, because you guys are going to be together, you know, rocking in this boat for a long time, so you might as well get used to it.
I remember when I was around, I first met my husband, and I never remember wearing a lot of makeup. I know I used to wear lip gloss and stuff like that, so my husband is not used to me, like, the way how I dress now, or this is not how he met me. And we went on dates where I was not wearing any makeup, I didn't have any weave in my hair, and it was normal. Like, he did not take any kind of offense to any of that. So if you have somebody that is really into you, but you need to be wearing weave all the time, or he can't stand seeing you without makeup, then girl, you need to get your life, because that's not the man for you. Okay?
Nope.
And then once you tie up all of that in a friendship, then moving into a relationship will make it even much more stronger. And then when you guys decide to get married and really connect and have that partnership, all of that stuff won't even matter anymore, because you already dealt with it within having a friendship.
Mm-hmm.
So, and this is kind of tricky, because this is for people that haven't met their someone yet. But if you have met someone, or you've been with someone for years, you just really got to take a step back and figure out what you don't know yet, and then how you're going to groom into going to the next step. So yeah, that's basically it.
Yep. All right. And the next point that I had down is definitely to be independent. No one likes someone, or you don't want to go into a relationship, you know, not being independent or not having yourself established or not knowing what you want out of life. And being independent is not necessarily saying you cannot be dependent, because to be in a relationship, a committed relationship, and to be in a marriage or going towards a marriage, you have to be able to, you know, be able to stand on your own two feet and to be able to be accepting of change. Like, you can't be living with your husband and, you know, like, you have a bill that needs to be paid, for example, and you're going to say, babe, you know you don't have it, and you're going to say, babe, no, I got this. I don't want you to do it for me. You can't be like that, because it's not going to work out. It's not. Or just like my mom would say, how you start is how you're going to end it. There might come a time when you really need the help, and you're going to ask him for the help, and he's going to be like, nope, you got it. That's not a healthy relationship. What do you think?
Yeah, I definitely agree on being independent. And also, independency is also, you got to really tie that into sharing, because a lot of people think independent, and you can be so independent to the point where you never want to take anything from anyone, or you never want to share anything with anyone, or you're like, this is mine. I work hard for this.
Yeah.
You know, so you can... Being independent, you got to figure out a way to tie it into your relationship, because you want to be working and you want to own your own, mm-hmm. but when you get married, it's not yours anymore.
Right.
My independency is your independency,
right.
and it's one. So, like, I work, my husband and I worked, but we split the bills halfway, and we kind of, it's kind of like, we're all of our money going into one bucket. We pay all our bills, and then whatever money we have left, we figure it out. You know, this is going into savings. This is what we're going to do for this. This is what we're going to do for that. Mm-hmm. Money aside, if you like to take vacation, like, you have to figure out your independency within your union and figure out how to make mm-hmm. it work, and try not to be selfish if you're the person that makes the most money. You have to figure out how to tie it into your union and make it work, and don't judge based on what the other person has. So mm-hmm. I mean, I'm not saying if a guy don't have no job, you should tolerate that. I'm definitely not saying that, but mm-hmm. he should at least be trying. I mean, people have jobs and they lose their jobs and they go on unemployment. Unemployment might run out. I mean, as long as the person's trying and is putting out the effort,
yeah,
I would say it's okay.
Definitely stick by him, just because even if he's not working, don't give up on a person, which is like one of the key points that we had. Just if he's not where you imagine your head that you want your man to be, don't give up on the person because he's not there yet. Give him time, especially if you know within yourself that, you know, he's a good man, and regardless of what, he's always going to be there for you. Well, during this time, you need to be there for him too, because that's going to determine whether you're going to get this ring or not, boo-boo, okay?
The next one that I have is communication. Oh, my Jesus. This topic right here, we could do a whole video
segment
on communication.
Yeah.
And this is not some... We're not just doing this video as a one video and whatever. We have already decided that we're going to have a two-part video, or probably make this into a series
mm-hmm.
of tips on relationship. But communication is such a major key in any kind of relationship, whether it's with a partner, whether it's with your parents, whether it's with your friend, whether it's with your best friend, whether it's with your coworkers, whether it's with your boss. Like, communication is one of the biggest keys in life, because if we're in a relationship and we don't speak about things, that don't make no sense. You gotta talk about money. You gotta talk about your finances. You gotta talk about what you like and what you dislike.
You gotta communicate
on your feelings. Like, one of the big things in communication when you first start dating someone is make sure that you know exactly what you're going back to, like what we said before, knowing what you want. That's communication. If you meet a guy today and he tells you, I definitely don't want no kids, like, I don't like kids, I don't want no kids, and then you love kids or you really want to have kids, you can't expect 5 years from now to be pressing him every day about wanting to have a child, and then he don't want to give you any kids because he told you that from the beginning. So if you know that that's someone that said that they definitely don't want kids and you definitely do want kids, if y'all didn't come to an agreement that later on in life, we can have kids later on, but I don't want no kids now, I don't know how that would work out. I don't know. Because
I mean, maybe his mind could change down the line. Maybe, just maybe. But if he's like adamant about, like, not wanting kids ever. Like, I'm not that, no, never, ever, ever, ever will I want kids. And you might want to have to reconsider or, I don't know, do something about that.
Yeah, I don't know how much I would want, how deep I would want to go into a relationship with someone if they're so serious about not having kids. Mm-hmm. Or it doesn't have to be kids. It could be traveling. Maybe you live in the United States and you with someone that doesn't like to travel. And you're free-spirited. You love to just travel. And when you want to go to Barbados, you want to go to Jamaica, you want to go to the Bahamas, you want to go to London. Like, if you're going to marry into a union with someone and you know every year you want to make that your tradition, or every year you want to go somewhere, or you at random times, mm-hmm. you just like to get up and book a trip and just go somewhere to relax, and you know that person definitely don't want to leave Brooklyn because, you know, Brooklyn is where it's all happening, then I'm just using this as an example. I don't know how well that would work. And this is within any situation. If the guy says that he doesn't like something at all and you know that you like it, then you really have to think about if you want to get deeper into that relationship, because someone wanting to have kids and someone not wanting to eat meat is two different things. Like, you don't have to eat meat, but I can eat it. And, you know, that's something simple. But having a kid is a big difference, you know. So you really have to know, really have to communicate with the person mm-hmm. on every single factor.
Yeah, just think about it. I'm not a mind reader, and I'm not going to sit and ponder and wonder about what the heck you're thinking about. Or I don't want you to be sitting there thinking about or even imagining what I might be thinking about. So you just need to communicate with me. I'm not a mind reader, and I'm not going to waste my time trying to, you know, imagine what's going on in your head. So we just need to communicate with each other to make both of our lives 10 times better.
Right. Communicate about everything, especially marriage.
Yeah.
If you just met a person, or if you've been with a person now for a few years and they've never brought up the topic, or they've never even discussed it, or it never came up in a conversation, or you've brought it up but they're avoiding it and they change the subject every single time, you really want to communicate about that, because if you don't want to be with a person 10, 20 years, 30 years before they consider marrying you, then you need to tell them that. You need to say, hey, babe, we've been together for a while and I've been thinking, what is your thoughts on marriage? Or, you know, like, what is your goals? What do you think in 5 years from now? Where do you see us? Where do you see this relationship going? Because you could be with someone and you could be with them for years and your relationship is stagnant.
Not going anywhere.
Not going anywhere. It's just sitting there. You guys might have great sex. You guys might do stuff together. You guys might have fun together. Anybody could have fun together. Not anybody, but, you know, you could be in a relationship where it's a good relationship, but it's just at the same place where it was 2 years ago.
And granted, if you're okay with that, then this obviously isn't for you. If you're completely okay with being in that spot, then that's you. You're your own person. You can, you know, make up your mind for yourself. But if not, then you need to, now reconsider. The next thing that I have is definitely to be patient, which ties into what we were just saying. If, you know, you're a person who, you know, wants marriage, or, you know, love the thought of being married, and you want to be married yourself, especially if you're with someone who you've been with for a long time, don't pressure them into be like, babe, where's my ring, like, I need to have it right now. Like, be patient, especially both of you guys are on the same page. You know that you want to get married and he wants to get married too, and you both know that you guys are the one for each other. Then you just need to be patient.
Yes, you can't force. I would never encourage anyone to force anyone into anything. Don't force him into going and buying your ring.
And the next point that you have?
Know his background. You definitely want to make sure that when you're seeking or building a relationship with someone and it's getting into years and it's going down that road of commitment, you definitely want to make sure that you know their background, you know where they came from, you know how they were raised, because that all has to do with your marriage. The way how a person was raised, majority of the time, is the way how they are. You have to really get to know their background and where they came from.
Mm-hmm. And to tie on to that and to end it, basically what we're trying to say is to know his background and to be able to be accepting of his background, because to be his wife just means to be that you're going to support him through whatever. He's not going to want to be with somebody who knows that this is where he comes from, but yet you're going to look at him funny or not want to be with him because, you know, so for example, he had a rough background or his family didn't have, you know, a lot of money or he was poor. He's going to want somebody who's going to accept him because of that. Yes, this is where I come from. My house might not be the cleanest, but at the same time, I would love for you to meet my mom. I would love for you to meet my sister. Are you not going to want to come to my house because I live in a certain neighborhood? You see what I'm saying? Like, so you definitely have to be accepting of him and his background, his family, and all of that stuff all in one. What I want to touch on is to not tolerate BS. And we all know BS, capital letters, BS comes with a lot. That's like a whole list of stuff. Don't tolerate BS, and to definitely speak your mind. Nobody wants someone who's shy and timid and, you know, can speak up if need be. If he does something that you don't like, then you need to speak on it. If he's a person who, say for example, likes to hit you, which you shouldn't be with someone who likes to hit you anyway, but if he raises his hand about to hit you one time, then that should be a red flag within itself. But if you do see it, then you need to speak on it. If he talks to you a certain way, then you should be able to be like, babe, you need to fix your tone. Or if he has infidelity issues, then you need to speak on that too. You shouldn't accept it, but you should also speak on it. Don't tolerate BS, okay?
No BS around here. The next one that I have is ties into her with the BS, is make sure that he's educated enough. And I don't mean educated enough as in he needs to have a master's degree or he needs to go to college of some sort. I mean educated enough as in knowing how to treat a woman, knowing how to want to get to know you, knowing how to love you, knowing how to appreciate you, knowing how to treat you like a woman, basically. That ties into everything. Like a man, that man that you choose for you, if you're with someone now that treats you like crap, call you names, attempt to put his hands on you, doesn't know that every once in a while we need to be pampered, we need to be getting taken out on a mm-hmm. date. It don't have to be an expensive date, sure, not enough McDonald's,
right?
But
I mean, we can go to McDonald's too. We can even stay in the crib. You can cook me up some whatever.
Yeah, it could be at home, you know, cooking a nice meal. Or sometimes they don't have to be cooking. I watch movies a lot of times where I see the guys go out, buy a nice little something already cooked, go home,
prepare
the table with candles, buy a bottle of something, maybe you like red wine, white wine, I don't know.
Or even some apple juice.
Exactly. Put something together with some nice music. Like, he just needs to be educated romantic, enough right. to know how to love you and to know how to appreciate you and to know how to treat you like the queen that you are.
So I'm just going to just briefly talk about my last point, which is you cannot train a man to be what he isn't. I'll say that again. You cannot train a man to be what he isn't. Even though this video is about how to get him to put a ring on it. Baby girl, if he doesn't want to marry you or if he's not committed enough to be in a committed relationship with you, that's not going to happen. You have to make sure that you set yourself up with somebody. You pray to God to bring you somebody who aspires the same things as you do. Simple as that.
Yeah, that's a tough one right there. You can't train somebody into what you want them to be. Mm-hmm. You can't change somebody into what you want them to be. You have to get to know the person, know what they like, let them get to know you, what you mm-hmm. like, right. and then you guys grow together. You can't, mm-hmm. People can't change people. So you just, yeah, don't ever try to do that. And I think that's about it for this video, guys.
Yeah.
Definitely leave your comments down below. Let's have way much more discussion. If there's any questions that you guys might have that we did not cover today, feel free to leave them down below because we are going to do a part 2 and a part 3 in on this video. Probably we probably turn it into a series, so definitely leave those down below. We want to know what you guys think, if there's anything that we can that you guys might wanted to add to what we said. Please definitely leave those down below, and yeah, let's have a great discussion.
Yeah, I also want to say, even though this video is titled How to Get Him to Put a Ring on It, I know we touched on like plenty other topics, but that's what happens when you get into a really juicy conversation, you get to talking about stuff. So, and I also want to state that what we said previously is definitely our opinions. We're not saying that this is what you should do or whatever. These are just our thoughts that we decided to, you know, share with you guys and just put it out there. So,
yeah.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Definitely give it a like. And what does a YouTuber say? Getting a like and a thumbs up, whatever, I don't know.
Definitely like this video, guys. Share it and subscribe to my channel.
Our channel.
And
my channel too.
And definitely go over to my sister's channel and subscribe to her channel. I'm going to try to link it down in the description box below so it's easier for you guys to get over there. That's about sums up this video, guys. Thank you again so much for watching, and we'll talk to you in the next one.
Yes, bye. Bye. Bye.